Well, so many high school seniors have missed out on so much already, and now many of them are wondering, what's next? What will college look like? Tonight, Lena Lai looks at what's next for Ohio's universities as they try to develop new normal planning.
College students across Ohio are heading back to campus in the fall.
Personally, I'm a little nervous.
For Ohio State junior Leah Merrick from Shaker Heights, there's excitement and worry. The university announcing all students and staff are required to report their body temperature on the school app before going to campus each day. Class sizes limited to 100, while others will continue learning online.
I don't think I'm getting the same level of education, but teachers are making really good accommodations.
Cleveland State also rolling out its detailed plans, including class sizes limited to 30 students, face masks required at all times. Students will have their own private dorms, and over 50% of classes will be in person, the rest online.
We've invested hundreds of thousands of dollars in technology to make sure this works. We've given students laptops. We've gotten hotspot access for students that can't get access to the internet. We're doing everything in our power to make sure that this experience is something that's meaningful.
Meanwhile, Kent State expects at least 60% of its classes will be held remotely, and fall break will be eliminated to cut down on student travel and potential virus spread. At Case Western, in addition to the usual mask and disinfecting requirements, there's plexiglass between some desks, and campus dining will be grab and go. College amid coronavirus.
If everyone's being smart and they're wearing masks,
forcing a new way to learn.
I think, things should be okay.
Now, because of the impact of the pandemic, most universities waived ACT and SAT scores for this fall. Ohio State taking it a step further and waiving test scores for next school year as well. Cleveland State may follow suit. President Sands says a decision is expected next month. Betsy.
Oh, my goodness. So many decisions to be made. And you have to wonder who's more stressed, students or parents? I think it's a little bit of a toss-up. That's true. Thanks so much, Lena.